8:40. We are late a bit today because the whole network here in Tamok went down. So we had to drive along the road to find some network to let people know where we are going and about our estimated time of return and stuff.
Tähän ei pystyisi tuota ilmaista megan venyttelyä.
Ooh, dude, I am not gonna be able to do that. But today, we are heading over to Blåbertinden, Blåberfjället, and to go check this north-facing Couloir, which I've never been in, but Miikka has been underneath that a few times, and he already went there, so we're gonna check if this Couloir is actually going to be something that we could put into the list, because part of the whole project is to go find something new also in the familiar areas to know if they would actually be worthy of it. I know the ride is gonna be nice if it's good, but I'm just not sure yet if it makes the cut with the aesthetics and the looks and everything else that I have in mind, but we'll see. Let's go check. It looks very interesting, but I don't know if it has the wow factor.
I've tried it twice and it has looked completely different before. It's so skinny now, and there's a ice fall in the end, a small one. So if the snow is not deep enough, I don't think it's worth to scratch it. We're a bit late. We have like 2.5 hours of daylight left, which is kind of the worrying part. But we have headlamps. Snow looks really good here, but I don't know, in the Couloir it looks kind of scratchy, but
I'm not worried about the snow, but I'm worried about the time. And I'm worried about the fact that the network is not working down there at the bottom and in the valley, and we're like 5.2 kilometers away from our car, so if something would go wrong, then what is our plan, you know? We don't have the satellite phone with us today. It's like the worst thing for my mind if the timing is tight, because it creates more tension, and tension creates more errors, in my opinion. So personally, I'm going mellow style and just checking how it feels. If it feels even a little bit not cool, I'll turn around and I come back.
I'm not doing the type 4 stuff anymore, so I'm on the same program. Yeah.
Right now we're here because the run might be super nice and the snow will be potentially really good. This is good training for the big lines also, so that's why I want to go higher up a bit, but you know. Man, I've been chasing a lot of powder in my career and I am done chasing it for the reasons that doesn't make sense for me anymore.
I didn't taste any powder last year, so I'm hungry. So hungry.
Voi olla aika tiukka paikka laittaa kamaat tuolla aivan ylhään.
Ei me sinne ylös asti mennä.
Mikko, laske iisisti. Tätä rennosti. Tää on just niinku... Mulla on ihan sellainen olo. Vena.
Nyt.
Noniin. Jaakko, Kopi, kuuletko meitä?
Kuulet.
Oletko valmis?
On, kamera käy.
Miikka, drop in. 3, 2, 1. Drop. Oh. Yeah, man. Take it chill. Drop. Holy shit. What the fuck? Well, it's done. This is way too early for that steepness in the Couloirs. I think this could be the next Olympic sport. Technical mixed downhill splitboarding.
Very technical!
On this first trip to Norway, we were able to complete two of the classic Couloirs from my list. This was only possible because we got extremely lucky with the weather and stable conditions. In fact, throughout the whole trip, avalanche danger was at scale 1 and 2, which is very rare for the early season. This was just an amazing start, and it proved that this whole adventure that I've set for myself could be possible to do. But now, it's time to wait for more snow for big mountains and go back to Finland to get ready for very different type of adventures.
The first time here for me. Can't believe it.